Welcome back to Elim Chiu TV. I have a good friend here who have started the social enterprise movement about 8 years ago, and I see him started from scratch to where he is today. And he inspires me all the time from listening to him, and you know, his vision for helping the less able is something that we all admire.
2006, I decided to do on this project. And very simple reason. In Singapore, I live in UK for many years. In 94, I came back, I realized that there's no beggars in Singapore. There's really no homeless people in Singapore. You go to Malaysia, Indonesia, you see them. And there's no disabled people in shopping centers. Don't have one. And that was the impetus behind going to do this. So, you see, my mommy always told me something. 0 to 25, you learn. You get your degree, you get your whatever it is. 25 to 50, you earn. You earn your money, you earn your reputation. 50 onwards, you must give back. Because the Chinese say, 生不带来，死不带去, you know? I'm not coming with anything, I'm not going anything. And that was always been my philosophy. I want to create a hawker center to engage everybody. I got four basic principles. First, I must skill them first. Cooking is a skill, right? After skilling them, I must have gainful employment. In the course of the years of understanding a bit about Singapore, I realized that a lot of these shelter workshops, people are not paid properly, you know? So I decided that if I want to do this, it must be gainful employment. The third thing I want to do is integration. So how do you integrate? Hawker center. Everybody comes to hawker center, rich and poor. And finally, inclusion. Getting people to accept people with disability who can cook. And this is still my biggest challenge. So I started not by finding money first. I started by finding successor. Who is going to take over me in 5 years, 10 years down the road? So I'm very lucky, I got a lot of good people around me now, that one by one I could. Then I went to, it's very simple, I just go up to see, what are you going to do for the rest of your life? You know, why don't you do something like what I do? That's how I sell it. So what I did is, I raised 200,000 for the remortgage of my office, and I put it in. It's, at that time my wife was saying that, either you buy the Mercedes Benz or you do this thing. I told my wife I'd do this.
Wow.
So, I went in, started with 4 stores at Balestier Market, and that's how it was built.
I remember your drawing.
Yeah, exactly. Can I have a copy of it next time? So what I did is I built the whole thing one bit by bit. So what I focus is 4 kinds of disability. Physical, that means loss of limb. Mental, schizophrenic, bipolar. Social, abuse cases. And finally, intellectual, IQ 70 below.
Elim, what I didn't know was it just blew. When I first started, a lot of people come. Wow, that's where I realized the solution that I have something that's quite unique. And it grow. Then what happened is that a lot of things I learned, that period at Balestier taught me a lot of things. I can share you the story later. And what I do, I grow from there. And I take on a lot of people. I train them, I place them. Then I start developing curriculum. In order to teach people, skill people, you need a curriculum. So I at that stage, I developed a food store management course. Meaning, you come to be a hawker, you know, how to do signage, how to collect money. And that was the funny thing. There's nobody ever had anything to do with hawker training.
That's right.
Actually, what I did is I took MBA, master MBA courses. I lowered down to hawker level. Cannot work. They don't understand what is supply chain management. So I break into item. So they're all together, 19 subjects. I built it together and I started this. Then I went to WDA to get approval. And that's how I got recognized now. Then a lot of people keep coming, different disability coming. So I start focusing on, I tell myself, when we do the next stage, I got to focus on different disability every time. Then what happened? Elderly. Now the lunch street card was actually started at that time. I realized a lot of people go to old folks' home. I was at a function, old folks' home, and I see a lot of old folks, you know. Actually, the truth is that a VIP coming, that all the old folks must sit there, right? VIP come, they must all clap, sing song, and wear the stupid hat. Then I ask the old folks, what do you really want? You know what the old folks people tell me? I want to go kai kai, I want to go out, right? And that's realized, don't yet. Every day stay in the home, right? They must be that bored. So I started this thing called Lunch Street for the Elderly. I promised myself every day I'll do 40. So the bus will pick up at old folks, bring them for city tour, come to lunch at my place free of charge. And how the model works is very simple. I need customers, correct?
Yeah.
I have 40 customers every day. Right. So the student got a chance to cook for the elderly. Then who pay? I get corporate to pay. How much is hawker food, by the way? Not much. And this go on and on and on. I started from there. Trying to train normal people is tough. Trying to train people with disability is even tougher. Sometimes you think of it, I really don't know, I don't have answer to a lot of the things. At that stage, I told myself, 200,000, lost, never mind, I just walk away. Then something, things happen all the time. Something must be pushing this baby, right? I saw a father with a disabled child, daughter came. Then he said, Mr. Koh, can you help my daughter? The daughter suffered from some kind of mental issue. It's called obsessive compulsive disorder. You know what happened? In front of me, right, the father said, the daughter saw the father picking hair in the morning. In front of me, you know, like eye to eye, she picked the whole face. She picked the eyebrows, she picked the eyelashes, then she scratched her face. Father snatched it away, she snatched it back again. That was a sign to tell me, yeah, maybe I should carry on. So I went to raise another $500,000. I started the second one in Kaki Bukit. And because I realized I can help these people. So at Kaki Bukit, I started 14,000 square feet with 14 stores, right? And I start building up. Then something happened. Mother with disabled children. For those parents out there, with a child who is challenged, don't give up. Every job, this child are special. So I started with a bookshop at Khoo Teck Puat. What I do is I took the parents in and the mother. You see, you must understand, mother with a disabled child has a lot of stress by the family, seriously. So I put the mother and child together, I run a bookshop. And I tell you what, you see the transformation of the mother. They have something to do now. The child has something. So the first one is a small one at Khoo Teck Puat Hospital. It's a kiosk. Then guess what? More people come. So I started the second one at NUH Medical Center. There got 16 people working there, and they are all Down syndrome. I went on to do a third one at Tian Fong Hospital, entirely mother with mental patient. So at the moment, the entire operation called Dignity Mama has over 29 people working there, selling second-hand books. Then a lot of people say, second book, are you sure you can sell? Most people don't understand. Children are still reading children's book, and people my age are still like to read a book, correct? All this, it's not there yet, right? And maybe one day change, but everyone is a model. I'd like to progress. From a kiosk, second one is a shop, third one is a muffin store. One by one, I progress now. I'm doing number four and number five now. And things got bigger and bigger, and that's when I won the President Challenge Social Enterprise Award, and a lot more people coming in.